San Juan City Mayor Francis Zamora denying his administration's involvement in alleged corruption in a cash aid distribution program. Johnson Manabat reports.
San Juan City Mayor Francis Zamora denied all the corruption allegations made against him by Senator J.V. Ejercito.
May concern lang po ako kasi po sa kakuha lang namin kanina ng pera sa tukad.
In a privileged speech on Tuesday, Senator J.V. Ejercito presented two videos showing a beneficiary from Barangay Balumbato in San Juan City claiming that he was approached by the staff of a councilor asking for a 6,500 peso cut from the 7,500 peso assistance under the DOLES Tulong Panghanap Buhay sa Ating Disadvantaged Displaced Workers Program.
Binigyan siya ng transaction code para sa Palawan Express at inutusan siya na i-claim ang 7,500 pesos na tupad. Pero sabi ni Counselor, 1,000 lang daw ang mapupunta sa biktima, sa beneficiary. Ang 6,500 pesos naman, ikakaltas at isasantabi para daw po kay Mayor.
A witness testified to an alleged corruption in the tupad distribution in the city where he claimed parts of it goes to Zamora's pockets. But Zamora questioned the authenticity of the videos.
Sino ho ba yung mga nasa video? Diba? Why don't they come forward? Ba't hindi ho sila pumunta rito para kung talaga bang merong nangyaring bigay ng pera o kickback? Ang dali-dali magsabi ng ganung paratang. Ano ho bang ebidensya meron sila upang patunayan na talagang tumanggap si Mayor ng 6-5?
A second video purportedly shows the collection of the alleged cut of the mayor. Ejercito said beneficiaries also claim that tupad funds are being distributed as cash gifts to barangay officials in San Juan during Christmas, 15,000 pesos for every barangay captain, and 7,500 pesos for every allied kagawad.
Hindi na tupad ang pangarap ng mabiktima ng ayuda scam, pero ang pangarap ng mga opisyales, tupad na tupad.
But Zamora insists the San Juan City LGU has nothing to do with the distribution of tupad funds.
Ang tupad program po ay sa ilalim ng DOLE. Yan po ay sa ilalim ng national government. Ibig sabihin, hindi po dumadaan sa San Juan ang pondo o ang sweldo na nakukuha nila. Ang aming tungkulin lamang ay maglista ng mga benepisyaryo, siguraduhin sila po ay kwalipikado at tulungan sila na magkaroon ng DOLE ID o tupad ID.
Senate Minority Leader Senator Coco Pimentel urged alleged victims to file affidavits. They may be called to testify before the proper Senate committees. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri meanwhile said it is very important to get to the bottom of various reports of ayuda scams. Ejercito's privileged speech was already referred to the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee and Committee on Public Order. Johnson Manabat, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Poll Body opens the bidding for the secure electronic transmission services to be used for the 2025 midterm polls. Our correspondent Victoria Tulad joins us for more. Victoria, over to you.
Hi, Stanley. Two groups submitted their bids for the 1.6 billion peso contract for the secure electronic transmission services for the 2025 midterm elections. These are the joint ventures of eBiz Solution Incorporated and IONS Resources Incorporated. This was announced during the ongoing bidding for the said contract here at the Palacio del Gobernador in Intramuros, Manila. Under the transmission component, electronic results of the elections will be sent to the consolidation and canvassing systems, to the National Board of Canvassers, and data centers, which will be accessible to different stakeholders such as COMELEC, the dominant majority and minority party, accredited citizens' arms, and the media. Hence, the winning bidder must be able to securely send the results from the 105,000 automated counting machines to these parties. It can be recalled that COMELEC unbundled or separated the contracts for the transmission and hardware, which includes the machines. According to COMELEC spokesperson, Attorney John Rex Laudianco, this will provide for a better check and balance since one company can give feedback on the performance of the other. One change that will be implemented in the upcoming midterm elections in relation to the transmission is the removal of the transparency server. Because of this, Laudianco explained that the results will be sent directly to the various mentioned parties. Hence, the quick count may be done at a faster pace. The poll body will also use VPN or virtual private network instead of modems to avoid having issues with the transmission. If the two joint ventures are declared eligible, they will undergo a post-qualification evaluation to further determine their capability. COMELEC intends to award the project by March. Stanley?
All right, thank you so much for the update, Victoria Tulad. Dozens of House lawmakers backing the proposed 150 peso wage hike, but some groups warn the move will not just hurt small businesses, it will also worsen the condition of informal sector workers. Vivian Gulia has more.
Labor groups staged a protest near the House of Representatives to call for a legislated wage hike as relevant bills were tackled by a House panel on Wednesday. Discussions and proposals to increase private sector workers' wages across the board have started at the committee level of Congress's lower chamber more than a week after the Senate approved on final reading a bill seeking a 100 peso increase in their daily minimum wage. At least 77 congressmen have shown support for and co-authored the House bill proposing a 150 peso daily wage increase, according to the bill's proponent.
Ang patuloy na pagtaas ng presyo ng mga bilihin ay lubhang nakakaapekto sa kondisyon at kalidad ng pamumuhay ng maraming Pilipino, lalo na sa mga minimum wage earners.
Three lawmakers from the Makabayan Bloc of the House of Representatives, meanwhile, are calling for a 750 peso daily wage increase to substantially address the gap between minimum and family living wages. Gabriela Partilis Representative Arlene Brosas urged the president to certify as urgent the wage hike bills and called for the abolition of regional wage boards.
750 is not just a random number, as it represents the average gap between existing regional minimum wage rates and the 1,200 family living wage needed to attend to food and non-food needs of Filipino families amid sky-high prices.
19 business groups and foreign chambers of commerce expressed strong opposition to proposals for a legislated wage increase, saying it will hurt micro, small, and medium enterprises and worsen the plight of informal sector workers due to higher inflation. The National Economic and Development Authority and the Congressional Policy and Budget Research Department of the Lower House also warned of possible negative economic impact should the proposed measures be enacted.
The proposed bills could slow down GDP growth and could trigger job displacement and accelerate inflation. At the same time, it could increase job informality given the higher cost of hiring workers in the formal sector.
The Confederation of Wearable Exporters of the Philippines told the panel that the proposed wage hike could trigger retrenchment of more workers in their industry.
They said, and I can quote this, this is a New York investor. It's like putting a nail in our it's like putting a final nail in our coffin. You're looking at 70 to 80% that we probably could, because it's
lose their jobs.
Because you have to understand, our biggest concern now is our competitiveness.
Instead of another round of mandatory salary increases, the group asked the government to provide monthly financial assistance of 1,000 pesos to minimum wage earners for 2 years to help cushion the impact of rising prices of basic and prime commodities. Some business groups also urged the government to bring down the cost of putting food on the table. Labor groups, however, disputed claims that wage hikes will lead to retrenchments, higher inflation, and slower economic growth.
Dagdagan lang ng 150. Karamihan sa kanila, maiangat na ng konti doon sa poverty line na iyon. Ang pera na yan, iikot dito sa ating ekonomiya. Lalakas ang demand, mas maraming maliliit na negosyo ang maitatayo sa paligid natin. In short, rather than creating more unemployment, we from the Federation of Free Workers look at this opportunity, itong pagbigay ng pagkakataon sa mga manggagawa na madagdagan ang kanilang sahod, na madagdagan pa lalo ang employment.
Yung wage increase po, hindi po dapat ipanakot na ito ay magtataas ng presyo ng mga bilihin. Mali po yon. Kami ay nangihingi ng dagdag na sahod para mabawasan yung profit, yung kita po. Kaya hindi po dapat i-transfer sa produkto or ipasa sa produkto para wala pong inflationary.
Dr. Gerardo Sicat of the UP School of Economics calls for caution in legislating a wage increase and advised Congress to take into consideration the impact of additional labor costs to the country's position in the global trading system. The House panel will continue its deliberations on the bills next week. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.